I just spoke moments ago, by the way, exclusively with Homeland Security Secretary Kirstjen Nielsen about her relationship with the president and pressing immigration issues. Great to have you, Madam Secretary.
Pleasure.
Thank you for coming to the set tonight.
Pleasure.
So you had a big, fiery hearing on Capitol Hill today. I know that's...
Usually do.
Yeah, it's always fun. And so this was a big day for you. Kamala Harris decided to hit you on the issue of separating children from their parents. Let's watch.
Your agency will be separating children from their parents.
And no, I would assume- what we'll be doing is prosecuting parents who have broken the law, just as we do every day in the United States of America.
I can appreciate that. But if that parent has a four-year-old child, what do you plan on doing with that child?
The child under law goes to HHS for care and custody.
They will be separated from their parent.
Just and like so we do in the United States every day.
It's the immigration sob story, as we call it on the radio, which is not to be diminished. These are heartbreaking situations. Yeah, how do you, as DHS Secretary, combat which the emotional push on this? How can you do this? And you kept saying, well, basically, this is the law. How do you deal with that?
Well, it is the law, as you know. And, you know, I had an exchange last week with a different senator that tried to cut me off and said, well, I know this is your philosophy. And I said, ma'am, it's not a philosophy. It's the law. If you enter our country illegally, we will refer you for prosecution. We will prosecute you. But as you know, for every sob story, we have 73% border assault increase. We have people like Kate Steinle. I mean, where is the compassion for the flip side of this conversation?
Yeah, the American people don't get the same treatment from Kamala Harris and others who we'll be quoting tonight in the show, because it's always a one-way street. And I think those who are charged with actually enforcing the law are always meant to be the bad guys. And yet the American citizens elected Donald Trump because they wanted that situation reversed. It's America first. You've actually done a lot, and a lot of this doesn't get discussed. H-1B visa abuse, that's bringing in foreign worker abuse. You're working with DOJ. You're working on other ways to protect the American worker. One of the things that is really frustrating is this asylum fraud.
Yeah.
We've been documenting it on the show. We have American lawyers flying down to Mexico, coaching clients. They say it's advising clients. What can you do on an executive level if Congress doesn't get off its backside and get this done?
It's really frustrating. I've got to be honest. I really share the president's frustration on this and that of the American people. I mean, the way the system works right now, the threshold under law is so low that about 80% pass that initial interview, but only 20% are granted asylum by a judge, which tells us that 80% of that is either just a flat-out fraud or somebody who thinks they can come here because they want a job here. That's not asylum. Well, I want to reunify with my family. That's not asylum. Well, I just would like to come to the United States. Not asylum. We have legal ways to do that, but it's not through asylum.
But we hear that there might be another caravan making its way up from Canberra. I don't know where we got the name caravan, but caravan, I guess it's a biblical, or people are coming up again because they feel like as long as they get to the border, they can get into the country, and they will ultimately be released, correct? Or are they not being released?
Well, we're metering, which means that if we don't have the resources to let them in on a particular day, they're going to have to come back. So they're going to have to wait their turn, and we will process them as we can. But that's the way that the law works. Once they come into the United States, we process them. So we've asked Congress to fix this loophole. It's a huge gaping loophole that we need fixed because it's so abused.
One of the other things that I think is very frustrating to the American people is the fact that we have these repeat border crossers, people who've jumped the border multiple times, have been deported, come back into the country, and yet they still get the, oh, my gosh, what are you going to do about the poor immigrants? Our communities are being shattered because of this enforcement. You have actually overseen a huge increase in border enforcement and workplace enforcement raids and so forth, which I think are being welcomed by the American people. But again, the media and the Democrats are hitting you for shattering communities.
Yeah, but let's get back to Kate Steinle. I mean, it's how sad is it that the Congress of the United States can't pass a law to simply increase penalties for criminals who have been deported who come back? The House passed it. We can't get the Senate to pass it. Also, in communities, you know, we just broke through a stash house last week. The gentleman had been deported four times and had finals orders of removal five times, and we're still dealing with him because we can't completely—the system doesn't work. So we deport him, and he comes back, which is why, as you know, we need a wall.
What's happening with the National Guard at the border? That was— a big controversy here in Washington. I travel the country a lot. It seemed, again, like the people are saying, well, it's about time. I heard that on radio all the time, people calling in, why don't we get the National Guard at the border? Why don't we get extra help? You have news on more troops now going to the border. Tell us about that.
Very appreciative of the support of Secretary Mattis, Department of Defense. So, as you know, we have about 1,600 now. With our second request, we'll have about 2,200. Originally, we were focused on Border Patrol support, but now we've extended it. So we're going to support the folks at the ports of entry and then also our intel and analysis. But it's a huge force multiplier. Huge force multiplier.
California, Jerry Brown saying we're not going to be assisting in immigration enforcement. What are the California National Guard troops actually doing? What are they?
So they are supporting CBP. They're just doing it behind the scenes. There are specific things that we've worked out. So they are supporting. We want each governor to do more. I've talked to each governor. I talked about once a month to give them the new border figures, what we're doing. We'll continue to try to get California to do more.
We just talked to Bob Goodlatte on the show, and he's very concerned about these immigration centrists, I call them liberal Republicans, who are pushing this new DACA amnesty right now and trying to, through this discharge petition, work with the Democrats, get it rammed through the House of Representatives at least. What do you want Congress to do and this president to get this immigration enforcement done the right way in order to satisfy his promises to the American people?
I think the president has been very clear on this, and it's very easy. We need a wall. We need to close the loopholes, and then we need the personnel and resources that we need. So apprehension without detention and removal is not border security. So we've got to have the beds. We've got to be able to apprehend, detain, and then remove. So that's judges, that's lawyers, the detention beds. But it's not—it's a very easy formula to have border security. I mean, border security is part and parcel to the sovereignty of a nation.
How many people about crossed the border last month in the United States, family units?
Yeah, so take the original caravan location. We have about 100,000 people that cross that port of entry each day. So most of that is legal traffic. But again, we're talking about, you know, millions, hundreds of millions of people that cross about 1.1 each day between the two borders. So it's a lot of traffic. But buried in there, of course, are those who are seeking to abuse the system. It's a broken system. We've got to work with Congress. Congress has got to close these loopholes.
We have a 203% increase in illegal border crossings from March 2017 to March 2018, I think, by family units. Overall, it's a huge increase. Why? What's going on?
Well, I think they know a couple things. Some of the loopholes are they know if they cross between the ports of entry that nothing will happen. If they bring kids, they'll be released. The kids will be released in 20 days under a court case, right? If they're criminal, they'll serve a little bit of time, but under a different court case, we have to release them in 6 months back into the communities, the criminals. If they're other than Mexican, we can't put them in expedited removal if there's children involved. So they know. They know better than Congress. They know better than most of us, the smugglers. So they know the loopholes. They're exploiting them.
Are you and the president good now? There was some concern last week. He's very impatient for change. I've noticed
he's,
that.
Yeah,
Madam Secretary, he can be impatient. That's a good
thing, though. He's frustrated, and rightly so. I mean, can you imagine? Here's the president of the United States saying, I want to secure this country. Americans must come first. And Congress is saying, yeah, we don't have time. We're busy. We got to go on recess.
You're here for the long haul?
I am. Yes, ma'am.
It's great to see you. Thank
you
so much for coming in tonight.
Oh, my pleasure.
We really appreciate it.
Thank you.